Hi, thanks for being here. So I had a conversation over dinner last night, and it made me start thinking, when I go to bed, I have this nighttime ritual, and I just kind of hug my pillow, and I think, I love this, and I love that, and I love this, and I love that, and I just list all the things of my heart that I love so much.
Must take a while.
Until I fall asleep. And my friend was talking to me, and he said, well, I've got a nighttime ritual, and I say thank you, and I have appreciation. And I was just thinking, I was trying to feel the vibration of love.
We like this conversation because it ties back into what we were tiptoeing in earlier about giving and receiving, about them being the same vibration. In other words, when you are appreciating what has been given, it's the same vibration as being thankful for what's been given. When you are appreciating, your appreciation is going out. So it causes this cycle. You can't be thankful without your appreciation. And think about what the literal fiscal definition of appreciation is. It's adding more to something. And so your question is?
I like to feel, you know, forgiveness is, to me, still got victimhood in it. So appreciation is much higher. And so I was wondering, like, where is, are love and appreciation the same thing?
They are equivalent vibrations, but we use the word appreciation more often because it's not as loaded with things. When most people use the word love, they're talking about their feeling lost love or missing love or not enough love. There's more of a lackful vibration energetically around your planet when the word love is offered. Now, of course, that's not always true. And when you are resonant with love, of course, use the word love. But appreciation is a better word for most people than love because it doesn't bring with it lack. But words don't matter so much. Words don't matter other than that they may prime the pump to a vibration that you've got going. But it's finding that feeling place. So sometimes appreciation of something that's right there, like your pillow, can put you in that vibrational place that will lead to more and more and more. But as you are drifting off to sleep, really, you're wanting to quiet your mind. The quieter you are in your thoughts, when you think about it, your inner being is in this place of non-resistance. Have you ever wanted to go to sleep, but you can't? And you really want to go to sleep, but you can't? Well, your mind is just too active, so you're not blending with what is sleep. Because sleep in its finest, we have not said this to you before, sleep in its most precise value is attunement or alignment with the energies of your source. That is the whole point. People say, well, what about rest? Well, you're resting while you're sitting here. Your muscles are at rest. In other words, you don't need to sleep to rest. Your body gets plenty of rest. But the benefit of sleep is that it quiets your mind and it gives you a greater opportunity to slow the momentums of unwanted and to pick up the momentums of wanted. So when you slumber, no matter what you're dreaming about, or even really no matter what thoughts come to your mind when you first wake up, you've accomplished a very good thing during sleep, because you have, as you have slept, as you have meditated, you have found resonance or harmony with the source within you. And so the potential for alignment is greater now that you've rested. And think about that. Think about that in terms of action versus allowing, making things happen versus letting things happen. Sometimes people are so determined to make things happen that they don't even let themselves sleep. They don't do the thing that is most conducive to connecting to the power that is who they are. We're not talking about long sleeps. We're not saying you need this much sleep. We're saying just allow yourself that time of alignment so that who you really are can step forward in the day with you. And the more often you do that, then the better every step forward into every day will feel to you, which is the whole point of all of it. Not one of you came. You didn't come here to get stuff done or to fix stuff that is broken or to change the world or to modify the world or even to figure out what's right and wrong in the world. You came to enjoy your exposure to life and your evolution, which is absolute. Yeah.
I had another thought. Sometimes I get, I'm feeling aligned and I will jump to quickly do something. And I would consider sometimes that's an impulse if I'm not as grounded. If I'm really happy and excited, I'll say, yeah, I'll do that too.
Well, you'll get better and better at knowing what satisfaction really is, because a lot of impulses come from pure alignment. But some things that you're calling impulses are jumping out of habit too. So after a while, you'll feel more inclined. You'll feel more inspired.
So I was considering it of impulse versus inspiration, but it's not always that an impulse can be bad. So I can have an aligned inspiration as well as an aligned impulse, I'm hearing.
Oh, we would put inspiration and impulse often in the very same category. In this conversation of thoughts turning to things, you're going to hear this now like you've never heard it before because of what you've already heard. So you're going to really like this. So vibrations will lead to thoughts, and thoughts will lead to more thoughts, and more thoughts, and more thoughts, and those thoughts will lead to things. In other words, this is a sort of rudimentary explanation of how things become here in your physical environment. And so the vibration that is without resistance will lead to such pleasing thoughts. A vibration that is without resistance must lead to pleasing thoughts. So if the root of the thought that you're thinking now is a vibration with non-resistance, then you're off on a really good foot. Did you follow that? Therefore, if you have meditated into non-resistance, and now there's a vibration that's not discernible. In other words, you can't think vibrations until they get some momentum going. So when you meditate, you allow enough momentum of the vibration to get going that you allow that vibration to turn to a thought. Did you see how that went? You didn't pick up some thought that somebody else had been thinking about that was maybe off course or on course. In other words, you weren't influenced by another thought through conversation, sort of like what's going on here. You allowed the very depth of who you are, the very source of who you are, the very soul of who you are, the very love of who you are, because you meditated and quieted your thought, you allowed that vibration to come into focus. So when the thought came, it felt satisfying. And if you liked it, and if you know that you liked it, and if you're also acknowledging that you allowed that pure thought to occur to you, you were ready to be ready to be ready to be ready. And why were you ready for the thought? Because you quieted your mind. You quieted your mind, so you were ready for alignment. And because you were ready for alignment, now you're ready for that vibration to turn to a thought. Ooh, this is how thoughts turn to things. But you're doing it on purpose. You allowed that vibration to turn to a thought. Now, in the beginning, that vibration may turn to a thought, and right on top of that thought are going to be thoughts that don't feel so good when you think them. Just say to yourself, I'll get better and better and better at this. But in time, you will be able to quiet your mind. You don't even have to go into a meditative trance. You'll just be able to hold yourself in that place where you center yourself. It's like starting at the beginning. It's like building a foundation of a skyscraper that's not stable, and no matter how much you try to stabilize it as you get it up there, in other words, you're trying to retrofit it and make it better and better, if the foundation is not stable, it's going to topple over in a little while. And the foundation of everything that you are about is your connection to source energy, and meditation is the path to that. And so thoughts turning to things, thoughts turning to things, thoughts turning to things, thoughts turning to things. But before thoughts turn to things, vibrations must turn to thoughts. So how are you going to get a good basic thought? How are you going to start with a really good thought? Start with vibration. Start with no thought and do it every day and feel the satisfying qualities of it. Feel it. Feel what it feels like to have non-thought, and feel what it feels like to feel your body sort of swooning in this energy of well-being. And there's not a thought in your mind, but you can feel. You can just feel well-being. It's not thought. You're not thinking about anything. You're not thinking about your body. You're just feeling the satisfaction of this non-thought. And as you allow yourself to stay there long enough, that non-thought, that vibration that now is being allowed by you to gain positive momentum because you're not crippling it with a contradictory thought, now it gets enough momentum that you think a thought, a satisfying thought, a satisfying thought. Sometimes that satisfying thought bursts into your mind and you feel like impulsively doing something about it. That's okay, do it. You'll feel more and more of that as you allow this. But so many of you start with a problem, a thought about a problem, a thought about a problem to which you want a solution. But in the activation of the problem, you're not ready for the solution. You want to jump right over there to the solution. Take me there to the solution. I'll know it when I see it. No, you won't. No, you won't. Start over here with non-thought and feel the satisfaction of this one, and then get ready for this one, and then get ready for this one. And then before you know it, it's not just thoughts. It's impulses to move. It's impulses to contact. It's impulses to rendezvous. It's impulses. Your thoughts are turning to things called action. Your thoughts are calling to things like meeting with other people. You see what we're getting at? It's just this evolution of you being guided from the inside out. And where's your inner being getting the information to which it is wanting to guide you? From your vortex. And how did that stuff get into the vortex? You explored enough contrast to put it there. Do you see why you can't get it wrong? And why you never get it done? And aren't you sort of kind of ready to begin to cash in your vibrational chips? Don't you realize how much you've done and how much is there? And aren't you willing to just relax for a little while and get ready to be ready? And to recognize that you're ready and not need to talk to anybody about it. You don't need to write a book about it today. You don't need to make a big hoopla about it. Oh, I had this insight and I must share it with you. They're not ready. No one's ever ready for your insight. Nobody's ever ready for your insight. And so you're always going to be misunderstood. And if you need to be understood in order to feel good, you're screwed. You are. You are. But if you're willing to come into vibrational alignment with who you are and ready to be ready to be ready to be ready, and then before you know it, the universe has lined up all these cooperative components who also were getting ready. You got ready for each other. Your soulmates are getting ready for you. You're getting ready for them. You're getting ready for your desires. You're getting ready. You're getting ready. And how do you know you're on the path of getting ready? You feel so good right now. And what does so good feel like? Feels like satisfaction. Sometimes it feels calm. Sometimes it feels interested. Sometimes it feels excited. Sometimes it feels just like hugging your pillow. Feels like lots of different things. Enough?
Thank you.
Really good. Really, very good. Very good.